Yeah, this is kind of weird, man. I mean, it feels great. There's no no hesitation. I can't wait to get this going this whole weekend. And when it first happened, I didn't know that we would ever be able to pull this off. I've been doing these football tours for almost 10 years now with ESPN. And we always kind of joked, well, too bad we can't ever go to UVM because there's not a football team. It is our football tour. And the sponsors got together, management got together, and they said, why don't we go up? And then it also coincided with homecoming and my 20-year reunion. So I love this place. I come back every year, if not twice a year. So to be able to come back here and do the show, like, this is going to be one of the great memories I've ever had in Burlington, man. You know, it's just going to be nice to be with my buddies because you know how this job works is that you get so busy, you rarely have any kind of free time. So to be able to roll in last night, watch some of the Pats game, you know, watch the Yankees playoff game and sit there with friends and sit in these places that we were sitting in 20 years ago and not miss a beat, just pick right up, make fun of each other. But it's cool. I mean, it's really cool that, you know, so many of my friends would come back. I mean, granted, we're coming back through the union, but to be able to come back and then have this moment where we'll do the show for the entire afternoon and people kind of stopping in. And then the funny part will be some people that probably have no idea what I've been up to the last 20 years walking by being like, why does he have all these signs everywhere? So, look, I love this place. So there's never any chance I can come back here, I'm always going to take it up. I would tell you almost everybody would have bet against it, but I don't know. It's hard to explain that. I always felt like I had it in me to pull something off, but it's just so hard. I mean, you know how it is. I mean, you're younger, you're in this business. It's just really hard. There's so many moments you're not making money. You think you're going to quit, but you just can't. You have to keep grinding, and you have to just not give up on this thing. And I, you know, look, to be at ESPN and have an afternoon show that's all over the country, I mean, that's obviously kind of the peak of what you want to be doing, but I don't want to sit here and say, I mean, it comes off almost as arrogant to say I'm not surprised, but like I had a lot of expectations for myself. It just took me a lot longer to figure it out. Yeah, it was great with hockey. Lacrosse was really good. I mean, obviously some of the Nordic sports, but we weren't super locked into those as students. But now with basketball and Coach Becker, who I just think is great. I love his story. I love what he's done with this program. And it's a basketball program that went from a cute little story and that was probably a novelty nationally when they would get into the tournament, and especially the Syracuse win, to now real expectations where you have a fan base that's disappointed if they don't win the conference, if they don't get back to the tournament. And that is probably as unlikely as anything. And I mean that in a positive way because it just wasn't thought to be that. And now it's a basketball team where Becker, who's great, but I was talking with him last night. I go, you have real pressure on you now. And he goes, yeah, it's a little bit different from when he took over the job. It's not really that weird because, you know, in a way, I've spent as much time here as I've spent anywhere else because I was here for school. I left. I was trying to get a job in the business. It wasn't happening. I was at home. I was working construction. I was sending out my one demo tape that was fake. And then I decided to move back up here. And I said, you know, I might as well just go back to Burlington because I like it so much. But I have family that lives here. I have a grandmother that still lives in Newport. My mother was born in Newport. So I'd have always had Vermont ties and would come up here every summer when I was a little kid. So it's not just that I went to college here. It's not just that I lived in the community and that I come back to visit all the time. I mean, I wouldn't call myself a Vermonter necessarily, but I have more connections to this than just, you know, stopping into Burlington once a year. I think we took a lot of pride in our intramural football, you know, not losing a game for 2 years. And we were really, like, annoyingly arrogant about it. If we had a big game, I would skip class. You know, I think that the best thing for me at this place was that I didn't get off to a great start. I just didn't. I didn't really understand it. You know, being from Martha's Vineyard and then being in a place that actually has food open past 8 o'clock, you know, living on Martha's Vineyard in the winter, like Burlington was like New York City to me. I actually was overwhelmed by Vermont in the beginning. I thought it was almost too big and I'd made a mistake. And in the beginning, it felt like I had made a mistake, but the school stuck with me. And then I did figure it out as I went along because I was here a while and this place stuck by me. And I think that making the most of this place, like anybody can show up to school and get through in 4 years and just kind of be done with it. But I had to go make sure that I got the most out of it the whole time. And basically, yeah, I'm not going to tell you any good college stories.